Hi, welcome back to my channel Ren Country 6. So we're going to carry on with this German Shorthead pointer. So what I've done is just taken a few basic measurements, and we've measured across from one side of the head to the other, and given ourselves some marks there. We've also measured what appears to be the width of these ears, and measured those out. We've done that by popping that in the vise, put a ruler up, and then measure across just to give us a rough idea. We already have the snout there. Just say we know that that's where we want to be there, and that's where we want to be there. So we're going to start moving material now, and we'll do it very slowly. We won't sort of rush into anything. What I'm probably going to do is take these lines out like that, if you can see a bit, and that won't be right, but as I say, I don't want to be taking material away when I don't need to, so I'll leave some there. I can always take it away as and when I want. Say referring back to the pictures, it's really going to probably come round like so. But so what we're going to do first is just block out. That's all we're going to do. So a couple of vertical lines there to dig that out. Might block the ears out, you know, very basic blocking shapes, and we'll see where we go from there. Okay, so I'm going to come right back once I've got my mask on and we've got geared up with the right bits and pieces, and we'll start carving. I wear my gloves in the initial stages and make sure I don't catch myself. Right, off we go. Thank you. Okay, so just basically blocking out now. Now, there's going to be a lot more having to come off here, because when you look at these ears, they're really sort of like, how can we put this? They're at that sort of an angle. So when you see things, you know, in two dimensions, you've got to remember that, let's say, you've got to leave material so you can get this angle coming into the edge. So there's going to be a lot more material come off here to give you that depth, but at the moment I don't want to go any further than that. So a bit on this ear, and we'll see how we go. Right, so again, I've just reminded myself of the distance between the central line and the outer part of that skull. That's 30 millimetres. So as I go across there, I can see that I've got quite a bit more to take off. So you keep checking, you know, don't take too much off to start with. You shouldn't go too far wrong. Okay, so we've taken a bit out of the sides there. Looking at the pictures, what I'm going to do now is where we've got this edge here, I'm going to smooth that out now so it's more of a concave, let's say. And as you can see on this picture here, you may not be able to see on the screen, but that curves nicely from the head into the muzzle. And it's almost the same on that one. So we're going to take that out now. Okay, so just measuring that snout on that picture, we can just take another 1/8 of an inch off this front, so that's what we're going to do now. Right, I think maybe the next thing to do is to get the angle in for these eyes. And obviously, you know, the dog's eyes are not flat on, you know, they'll be off at an angle like that. So I'll try and get that right. I've no idea what angle it is, so what we'll just do is do this until it looks right. I think I might put a smaller abrasive drum on. Now we're going to use that smaller abrasive drum because we're in a smallish area, so it shouldn't impinge on other areas too much. The other thing I'm going to do is stop this video now because we're at 22 minutes. I'm going to try and keep them in, you know, reasonable blocks, so it's not too much to watch all at once. So this is the end of this one, and then as I say, we'll start again on the next one for another 20 odd minutes.